Then the RBI rules, regulations will prevail. But on a sectoral issue, conflict of saying that 49% hai ya 26% hai ya allowed hai, automatic route hai ya RBI approved route hai, that only the FDI policy can.
Sir, as far as the conflict is concerned, as far as possible, we could go for a harmonious construction. But then when that is also not possible, because a policy is not a law, that's a vision document. And a notification is a notification or a notification is a law according to the Article 13 of the Constitution. That is a law. What is notified is a law. So when there is a conflict between a vision document and something which is technically law as defined in the Constitution, so don't you think the
The general rule should be that the law should prevail, but let me tell you that this, wherever this sort of conflict is acting on the sectoral policy, because that is only where the FDI policy will prevail and not the regulation. Wherever there has been a conflict, we haven't seen a situation which says one is sun and the other is moon. You know, never been that type of situation. Yeah? You'll always have situations, okay, in NBFC we have a condition once that you have to do some minimum capitalization and then a percentage limit, and then there was a doubt, okay, how do you interpret this versus this? So the literal interpretation of the regulation was not clear, and therefore when it was not clear, you could have always fallen back on the policy document to say the objective intent behind this was this, therefore you read this in light of the FDI policy. So I will say that, you know, why I'm saying that the FDI policy and sectoral will apply is because it will always be that the regulations do not say exactly the opposite. It will only be unclear in the regulation. Therefore, you can always fall back on the policy, which means that the policy will prevail ultimately over the wherever there is a doubt in the regulation itself. Yeah, if the regulations, if any reason in the future it comes and the regulations say FDI is under the automatic route or auto approval route, and the FDI policy says it is under the automatic route, then of course the regulations are. You have to change the regulation. It will never be. The government of India cannot go to a foreign investor and face it and say, "Rehik me approve the automatic, rehik me approve." It will have to change. So, whenever those type of extreme situations will happen, the law will always be not that way. It will never be honest. There will always be lack of clarity when the language of the regulation is unclear. You know, if you see now also what happens is that the government FDI policy also, when they put the sector and the conditions, they put it in the form of a law. You know, they put it in double quotes and all that, you know, basically. So it is exactly that way it is reproduced ideally. You know, that is the whole intent and purpose also. So now they have tried, earlier they were not doing it, but now they have made it very parallel that it reads the same. It should read the same. Again, the issue of multiplicity of laws, that why you need to read two things to come to the same answer. You should have only reading one. So maybe in future it will change, but today what it is, but I don't see that sort of a big difference, you know, happening. Okay, so we'll move a little faster on this. I think we've just to summarize how do you get to the correct answer. The first most important thing is understand the transaction. Very clearly, don't assume anything in the transaction. Make sure that you know exactly what is happening, because unless you know what is the subject you have to deal with, you will not go to the right place. You know? Unless you know where you want to go, you start from Goriyoli or wherever, you don't know where to go, you will go to anywhere it takes you. But please understand the transaction, that is very critical, and then you follow the act, rules, regulations, current account, capital account, different answers, you know, include analysis, maintain record, do you still have queries, get the banker's clarification, better, if they're still in doubt, go to the RBI and see their clarification on approval, you know, you can follow, I mean, these are then the things. I won't want to go into all of that in detail. Just very quickly, just sum it up in terms of when you're reading exchange control regulations, etc., just keep in mind it is not a act always, you know, FDI policy, consolidated circular, APDR circular, FAQs, these are not always act. They are not framed as if it is section so and so and then provides so and an explanation and definition, you know. So keep in mind the spirit of anything and everything and not just go by the literal words of anything. You know, keep in mind the spirit, that is very, very important than just going by the pure wordings of any law. Policy paper, always cross-refer, never assume, FEMA is not income tax, although this is a controversial statement. I mean, you don't need to read the FEMA Act as an act, but as an income tax. It's a controversial statement, so I'll allow people who want to differ on this. I'll not go into that, but you know, it's not the act. Some very basic principles, you know, you have to always make sure when you read it, whether the transaction is a capital or a current amount. This is the first determination you need to get into, you know, always find out whether your transaction or the subject matter you're looking at is a capital or a current account transaction. Then keep in mind that the FEMA regulations will have different answers depending on your residential status. Whether you're NRI, not an NRI, foreign company, Indian company, the answer may be different. And the nature of the transaction, current or capital account, permitted or not permitted. And the last bit, you know, if I, when I used to start my accounting, Deepak classes used to be there, you know, Deepak used to say the three rules of accounting, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So I keep this as the debit what comes in, credit what goes out of for FEMA. And the last principle is that a capital account transaction is generally prohibited unless specifically permitted. Whereas a current account transaction is generally permitted unless prohibited or regulated. That's the way you need to interpret. So if you don't find something on the payment that you're doing, don't be afraid. Or it's like that. You know? So be very clear on some of these things. And I'll not go through this, there's a useful website if you want to refer, you are there in the printed document that are there as to what is available where, so you can easily go through. Sorry.